Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for joining us yet again on another Guild Debate here on Urban TV. My name is Casmil. Now, previously, last week, we hosted Kampala University Original, where two candidates battled it out, and these included Solomon Atenyi and Bikumbi Asuman. Now, news reaching Urban TV today is that Bikumbi Asuman is the newly elected Guild President of Kampala University Original, and we just want to say congratulations to you, brother, and we hope your time is going to be the best that KU will ever have. And tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we take on another private university that was accredited and established in 2007. And tonight on the podium, I'm talking about Muteesa One Royal University, Mengo Kakeka Campus. Now, the Electoral Commission of Muteesa One Royal University vetted two candidates to run for the Guild Presidency, and these include Chibuka Joseph and Kalumba Arthur. And those are the two candidates we have on the podium. Looking at their profiles briefly, Honorable Chibuka Joseph does a Bachelor of Commerce. He's in year two, and his slogan says, "United we stand for Muteesa One Royal University." And the second candidate we have in the house is called Kalumba Arthur. Kalumba Arthur does a Bachelor of Mass Communication, year two, and his slogan is, "Our time is now." Gentlemen, good to have you in the house tonight.
Thank you.
I'm talking to Mr. Arthur.
Yes, sir.
How are you doing?
I'm all right.
How is Muteesa One Royal University?
Muteesa is doing well.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. And Mr. Chibuka Joseph, how are you doing tonight?
I'm doing well.
Welcome to Urban TV. Have you ever been here before?
Not really, but yeah, it's my first time.
All right. Now
and I'm happy to be there.
Talk about. And of course, we're going to talk about the key issues affecting the university, why you are contesting, and so many others. So let's first take a look at their visual profiles. When we come back, we fill in the usual debate, and of course, it starts officially.
My name is Chibuka Joseph, a student from Muteesa One Royal University, pursuing a bachelor's degree in commerce. And aspiring Guild President 2018-2019. I went to Namwaya Church of Uganda for my primary education, then Meridian College for my O-level certificate. From there, I went to Greenlight High School, Zana, for my A-level. And now at Muteesa One Royal University, aspiring for Guild Presidency 2018-2019. Please offer me your mandate.
Kalumba Arthur is my name. A student from Muteesa One Royal University, Kakeka Mengo Campus, pursuing bachelor's degree in mass communication. Aspiring Guild President 2018-2019. I went to Centenaries Primary School for my primary level. Then I went to Chibuli SS and Kako Senior Secondary School for my O level. Then after I went to Natete Muslim High School for my A level. And now I'm at Muteesa One Royal University, Kakeka Mengo Campus, aspiring Guild President. Please offer me your mandate.
Those are the two candidates running for Guild Presidency of the mighty Muteesa One Royal University, Mengo Kakeka Campus. Back to you, gentlemen, starting with you, Mr. Chibuka Joseph. Your slogan says, "United we stand for MRU." Why did you consider that slogan? What does it mean? And take us through your manifesto, briefly.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Good evening, viewers. Chibuka Joseph, once again, is my name. And I took this slogan that runs that United we stand for MRU. Why? Because I strongly believe, that without support from others, very few things can be achieved. Therefore, to achieve as much as possible, we need to unite as a team. Just imagine. You cannot hold a fork using one finger. So when fingers become many, they can hold the fork and do the service.
Okay, I understand you're contesting. Can you briefly take us through your manifesto? through, what should we expect from you, given the fact that if you are voted into power of this university?
Once I'm voted into leadership of the mighty Muteesa Royal University, Mengo Kakeka campus, I'm going to put emphasis on the following. One, seeing to it that student leadership becomes more student-centered than it is currently. Secondly, looking into the students' welfare. That takes us to, one, the hygiene around the university, the seating facilities, and perhaps the general welfare, that is, students, to see to it that the talents of different students in the university are catered for.
We're gonna pause it there, and before you pass the microphone to Mr. Honorable Arthur, I'm sure this university has a motto. Could you be knowing the motto, because we have a new audience watching for the very first time and they've never had Muteesa Royal University? What is the motto of MRU?
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Muteesa Royal University, the mighty university, has a motto that states it that seeking greater horizons in thought and action.
All right, thank you very much. Pass the microphone to Mr. Kalumba Arthur. You are Muganda?
Yes, sir, I'm a Muganda.
All right. Now, your slogan says, "Our time is now." So what exactly do you mean by this slogan, and what are you trying to put out there to the students? And take us briefly through your manifesto.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. My slogan goes, our time is now. Yeah, fellow students and fellow viewers, I know Muteesa came from far. Many leaders have passed through Muteesa, but there are many things that have been left on the way. And I think this is the higher time. This is our time to make sure that all these challenges that have been in Muteesa that are whipped away. Going through my manifesto, Mr. Moderator, I'm an inspiring good president. And if you vote me into the office of the good president 2018-2019, these are the things I want to clear. Poor sanitation at the university, we're having the insecurity around the university premises. We're having a limited internet at the campus. So I'll make sure these things, I work hand in hand with my team, with the help of the administration, to solve these challenges.
And are you attached to any political party?
Yes, sir.
Which party is that?
I'm a candidate from FDC.
So you're representing FDC. Shout out to everybody watching in, and you're in support of FDC. And Mr. Joseph, are you also attached to any political party?
Chiroka Joseph is not attached to any political party. He's an independent candidate.
All right, you're an independent candidate. And right. Tell us through. We would like to know, because you choose to run for guild presidents, have you held any post in the previous government?
No, I haven't held any, please.
Okay, in all your lifetime at school, where exactly have you held the biggest position when it comes to leadership?
Perhaps in my life, I've held the biggest position at my place of work. I'm a director of studies in Blessed School.
You're working.
Right.
Director of studies.
Right.
So how do you handle both? Like, you're a director somewhere, and how are you going to be able to help the university when you're so busy like that?
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Chiroka Joseph believes that most of the people who are busy are the best time managers. I've already allocated time, and I've looked into my schedule, and I do really have time to put a break on the students' leadership in Muteesa, the first Royal University.
So in case of an emergency comes up, your timetable has been laid, and of course you're serving. Don't you think, in case of an emergency, it's going to affect your work at where exactly you work, and then you have to serve the university? Because I believe you as a president, there is a lot of tasks that are going to be laid for you to finish.
Okay, thank you, Moderator. In all sorts of leadership, there is what we call delegation. And I do believe that being given the opportunity, I'm known to lead alone. I must have a cabinet, and through delegation, I do believe I can conquer with whatever emergency may come around, because under me we shall have a vice president and the rest as the hierarchy goes. So I believe...
Should I imagine that in your primary schools and high school you never held any leadership position?
Right, I did, only that you asked me the biggest that I've held before.
Yeah, I would say, okay, fine. And any other when it comes to school?
When it comes to school, I served the post of deputy head prefect.
Deputy head prefect.
Right.
In your high school?
Right. No, O-level.
O-level.
Right.
O-level.
Yeah.
All right, so now, should I imagine, Mr. Chibuka Joseph, you believe in serving two masters?
I believe in serving two masters as long as one feels like he or she has the potential to do so.
Okay, pass the microphone to Mr. Arthur. Mr. Arthur, do you also believe in serving two masters? Do you agree with him?
Yes, I agree with my brother, because when someone has the potential, if someone is willing, you can serve two masters at a go. I don't see why you couldn't serve two masters at a go if you're having that potential, Mr. Moderator.
All right, now talk about your highest position held when it comes to high school or any other place that you've been.
Yes, I've got a chance that on the previous regime that is ready to hand over, I've been the information minister, and I was the GRC mass communication first year.
All right, and in case you're watching the show, we don't want to leave you out of this mighty debate we have tonight. You can as well join the conversation on social media by going to our Facebook page, that is Urban Television. First thing first, like the page, and of course you can comment or send any question you like to any of the candidates we have here tonight. And then our Twitter handle is Urban TV Uganda. Follow us, and of course you can tweet and retweet anything or comment about anything that we are posting about the debate tonight. All right, there are so many key issues that are affecting Muteesa Royal University. If we were to look at all of them, what exactly is your main focus?
Okay, Mr. Moderator, thank you. Among the key points that are affecting Muteesa in the students' community, we are having the marks that are missing, and marks always goes very, very late into the portal. So I think that's the main issue.
Missing marks. It's the main issue.
Yeah, it's a main issue at our university.
And that is that is the main priority among
and
others.
And that's my main priority among others that All I right, want
how about
to work
you,
upon.
How about you, Mr. Chibuka Joseph? What's your main priority? What are the key issues that are affecting that university?
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. As you've said, there may be so many issues, but the key ones, according to me, in my opinion, when you look at the hygiene of the university, it is really alarming. Then secondly, the entire student's leadership, it's a time it went into, or it became more student-centered than it is currently, in my opinion.
All right, hygiene is one of those things that you prioritize.
Right.
All right, now what kind of strategy, now given the fact that if students believe in you and give you the vote, what kind of strategy are you willing to hold down to make sure that the hygiene, the sanitation of Muteesa One Royal University Mengo Kakeka changes?
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. If I'm given the responsibility of leading the students' fraternity in the mighty university, that is Muteesa the First Royal University, the issue of sanitation, one, I'm looking forward to engage the administration in intellectual dialogue, like as in informing them about the state of the hygiene in the university. Secondly,
the dialogue has been done by so many of the previous governments.
Right. But this time around, maybe they've been engaging in this dialogue without presenting a possible solution. In my view, I'm looking forward to see to it that the university, at least on top of what or the way they were using to manage wastes and the garbage, we as well install an incinerator to help in maintaining hygiene of the university.
Okay, you know, we're talking about things that you prioritize, and talked about sanitation, and he was talking about missing marks. So when it comes to the issue of missing marks, you as a person, what kind of solution do you have for that? Before we could hear from Mr. Arthur.
Perhaps for the issue of missing marks, I have if at all we are doing tests, say, tests all exams. I think it's a time the registration or the attendance that is carried on, it is kept in safe custody, in that if at all one misses marks, he can go back to the respective faculty and claim for marks. And in this, when he claims, I pray that such lists will be brought out just to clarify whether this student wrote the exams or not.
All right. And now checking on social media briefly, someone is asking you, can you, Mr. Chibuka, prove or give reference that you were a deputy HP somewhere? This is like an hobby of yours, Rex Basha.
Perhaps I was a deputy.
He believes that you're lying to us.
Perhaps he shouldn't believe in that. Why? Because I've presented a certificate in that to the Electoral Commission of the Mighty University, Muteesa the First Royal University.
All right. Okay, pass the microphone to Mr. Kalumba Arthur. You talked about missing marks, and I'm wondering what kind of solution do you have for that? What have you laid down for that?
Oh, missing marks. It's really amazing that students at our university really pay the tuition in time, and you find out when these students, some of them are thrown out of the exams, but you find during the middle of the semester when results are not there. So many students are complaining about that, they're missing marks. Many of the lecturers tend not to put the marks on their portal. But I'm laying a strategy. When I'm into the office, I work hand in hand with my academic minister, hand in hand with the administration, and to see that all the faculty deans, we sit down and we see what we can do about that issue.
Okay, and then sanitation, his main priority, if you talk about it, because this is some university, what are you planning to do when it comes to sanitation? I've been to your campus quite for some time, and I've really seen that sanitation is a very big problem.
Yes, Mr. Moderator, my brother is not lying. The fact is the sanitation is not all that good.
What is the problem? Where does the problem come from? Is it lack of orientation of students, or maybe the guild is not doing its position to make sure that things get changed? Because we see that year after year.
For the guild issue, the guild has tried their level best, but there is no cooperation between the guild and the administration to see that the sanitation is always clean through providing the cleaners. So I'll just make sure we work hand in hand with administration to see that they improvise us with more cleaners to see that they can make our compound and the university clean.
All right, thank you so much. And of course, so many questions are coming through on social media. You can join the conversation that is on Facebook, Urban Television. Go and comment and send in those questions. We shall, of course, ask those questions to the candidates we have in the house. And somebody's asking here, do you know the chancellor of your university? Who's the chancellor?
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Our chancellor, she's Miss Septinde. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. That is right. And who's the Vice Chancellor, Mr. Chibuka Joseph?
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. The Mighty University Muteesa the First has a Vice Chancellor in the names of Professor Umal Kasule.
Umal Kasule. And where does Mr. Arthur Seruanga, where does he lead? Because I saw something like Vice Chancellor Arthur Seruanga somewhere.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator.
I need to be corrected.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Those who have been following issues in the Mighty University, previously there was a strike, a serious one, and this was followed, one of the resolutions that were passed by the University Council, they suggested and perhaps requested Professor Arthur Seruanga to resign, and therefore we have an acting Vice Chancellor in the name of Professor Umal Kasule.
Umal Kasule, thank you so much for that clarification. And of course, these candidates didn't come alone tonight. They have a live audience they come with, their supporters. I'm sure they also have questions, and later on we shall be taking their questions after the break. But for now, we have a major issue that is happening all around the country, not just in Muteesa One Royal University, but across all universities. Recently, we just also lost, one of the victims was from YMCA, rampant kidnapping of girls and killing them. And that is an issue of security. You, as Mr. Chibuka, what are you going to do to make sure that students of Muteesa One Royal University are safe from such things, especially that we are going in for the freshers?
Thank you, moderator. In the first place, I'd like to put this right, that security begins with individuals. Before other security organs come in, dear viewers, these sisters of ours need to be keen about their security. But again, coming back to our university, I'll say to it that one, the security we have at the gate is as well improved. That is through intellectual dialogue with the administration. But again, I'll suggest, and I will get into dialogue with the administration, that at least we shouldn't have one gate. Because I'm looking at a situation where maybe the one gate we have into the university.
I'm looking at the freshers who are joining.
Right, the freshers who are joining.
What are you exactly going to do for them? Because being in dialogue with administration, yes, we'll talk and talk, but don't you think, is there any other solution you can come up with?
Thank you. Perhaps for the freshers who are looking forward to joining Muteesa, the First Royal University, I'm given the opportunity. We are going to take them through sensitization, that is during the orientation week, so that they get keen with their security first, because security begins with individuals.
Have you recorded such cases at the university before? Are you aware of any that has ever happened before in the history of the university?
Perhaps at other universities I've recorded some, but God has so far been at our side, that at our campus we have not so far registered such a case.
All right, thank you very much. And Mr. Arthur, what do you plan to do when it comes to rampant kidnapping of girls? What exactly, how different, how unique is your strategy from him? How better is it to make sure that the people who are watching can entrust you with a vote and you're the next girl president?
Okay, Mr. Moderator, yeah, it's very absurd that the issue that is going on in our country, kidnapping, and it's really, really pity for our nation. But I think when I'm into the power, I think when the freshers are in with the continuing students, first, we need to sensitize, as my brother said, but still, I just encourage the students to move in groups. Don't move alone, because you know moving alone is it's a risk thing. When you're moving around, someone can use that chance of grabbing you away from that way. But when you're in a group, so moving with your identity cards, which can identify you, at least it even shows something and it can help you from being kidnapped.
Okay. Yeah. Remember, people who are watching at home tonight, on the podium, we have two candidates battling it out from Muteesa One Royal University, Mengo Kakeka campus. How many campuses do you have? Are they two, Masaka?
We're having three campuses.
Masaka, one in Masaka?
Masaka, Kampala, and Mubende.
Mubende campus. Thank you very much. And of course, we have a live audience. After the break, after sipping some cold water, we're going to take questions from the live audience. I've seen your messages coming through on Facebook. I'm going to be reading them later on. Otherwise, keep it locked on Urban TV. See you in a bit.